I want you to know that it's very important that we get out here and show our voice, show our concern, and let these people that are polluting our neighborhood, let them know that we don't want them to pollute our neighborhood. We need to let them know that we deserve better. We deserve better. And I love the lady's sign that says, "This wouldn't happen in Lincoln Park." Yeah. That says it in a nutshell. Why does this ward always get landfills and industry and dirty, rotten pollution? We deserve better. We deserve better. Keep up the hard work. We have already won the fight of getting the North Terminal closed at the Petcoke facility. Never doubt. Never. That is a win. That is a win. And it's because of your hard work. It's because of our hard work together that got that done. Don't stop fighting. My election, our election, was a testament that people can beat big money.
Yeah. That's right.
People can beat big money. So don't ever underestimate that a group of concerned citizens can change the world, because indeed, it's the only thing that ever does. Thank you. Fight, fight.
Anna Johnson. Anna Johnson is from the Jeffrey Manor neighborhood. She's been a long life resident, 40 years. She knows firsthand the problem of Agri-fine. The interesting thing, everybody who doesn't live in these neighborhoods, when the wind is out of the east, Jeffrey Manor gets it. When the wind is out of the west, Slag Valley, my neighborhood, gets it. But there's no escaping it. Anna?
Hi, Anna Johnson. I have lived in this community over 40 years. I've lived in this community over 40 years. My family was here before Agri-fine built. And we're still here, and they're still here, and we want them to go. My parents was able to hand down their home to us. A lot of us, the homes that we buy, that we have, that we live in, is the only thing we have to hand down to our children or our grandchildren. While we have it, we still want to be able to be out in the yard, enjoy our property, enjoy our family and friends, enjoy the weather. You can't roll up your windows and enjoy a nice summer, spring, fall breeze without the smell of Agri-fine coming inside and ruining it. Just closing your windows is not the only thing that's going to help. It also seeps into your homes through the cracks of the brick or the cracks of the wall. We must take care of this. We must take care of our families, our children. Once that chemical gets into your body, there is no way that it's going to come out of. There's no way to get it out of you. It's in there, and it's in there. Agri-fine is making our life and our well-being and our children's health and our seniors' health bad. Let's get them out. Make them accountable. Let's do this. Agri-fine must go.
Yeah. Hey, hey.
Ho, ho. Agri-fine must go.
Next, I'd like to introduce Michael Oganovich. Michael Oganovich is a lifelong resident of Slag Valley. As a matter of fact, he's one of the first people I got to know when I moved into the neighborhood. We played bocce ball together for how many years? And how many years did we beat you? I forgot. In any case, Mike, Mike will tell you he's experienced this like forever.
Yes.
All right. Look at him, Mike. Look at him, Mike.
All right.
Well, it's great to see everybody here. We had this meeting May 2nd, those of you that came to the May 2nd meeting about Agri-fine. We had the state's attorney there. We had the Illinois EPA there. Just a few minutes ago, a good friend of mine, Patty Villa, is right here. Patty's got two sons. Patty just moved into a neighborhood. Both their children have asthma. Okay? Not saying these guys caused it. Like I said, on May 2nd, we have a lot of senior citizens at Vets Park. We have a lot of children. I live right across from Vets Park, the park. The other day, I was doing some gardening, and we have a lot of daycares. And about 25 little ones came to Vets Park. The smell was atrocious. And these guys stayed about 5 minutes. And we see that a lot where children, senior citizens, and the people in between, they just can't. I got a hat on, says America. We have rights, don't we? We have the rights. We have rights to, yeah, we have rights to keep our windows open. Okay? We have rights to be able to live. You know, we have problems with this company because, number one, the day may come, guys, that one of our most biggest investments we have are our homes. And who the hell is going to buy, excuse my language, that's in the Bible. who the heck's going to buy our homes with this smell? Seriously, okay? But I don't plan on moving anywhere. Like yourself, I'm 53 years in this neighborhood. I came over when I was 12. Do the math. Anyway, they have not been cooperating for many years. I would call Pat Carrillo's here. Pat, been keeping a track of all the, maybe for 30 years we've been calling 311 or the alderman's office, the former alderman, saying, what are we going to do about this? And nothing was being done. In fact, these guys expanded without any permits, with what I heard. Okay? But we have rights too. We have rights to live there. We have rights to live here. Okay? I'm old enough, and some of you might be also, where we lived during the smells of the steel mills. They weren't as bad as these guys. The landfills. I mean, these guys are pretty bad, you know, and they just seem, and all they do is pay the fines. And they give money to the schools, Sacred Heart, Marsh. By the way, Marsh and Sacred Heart, right over there, it's got 1,000 kids. 1,000 kids come in this neighborhood every day. They live here, some are bused here, and they gotta smell this stuff. Sometimes, a lot of times, Marsh School or Sacred Heart is using Vets Park for intramurals, you know, stuff. They can't do it. Or they're doing it and they're suffering because of this smell. We need, again, Sue said, we should, you know, and also Peggy said, we should have hundreds of people standing here. We really should, but who cares? Like my father said, worry about who comes to the party, not who those that don't show. This is just the beginning, guys.
There you go.
You know, this, we can't, you know, we can't fall asleep because they ain't gonna fall asleep. These guys are making money. And like we said, they're not gonna go away. If they stop making money, they'll go away. They ain't going away. Me and Sue and Peggy and Olga, we went to a meeting, and Nick, you know, they were very, you know, we were very polite, but the smell is coming back now. We gotta have that lawsuit. The only thing they're listening to is that lawsuit and the thing with the Illinois EPA. Okay, so again, you know, again, I don't want to get back to the sayings, but the saying is really true. We have to stick together. Right. We have to stick together to just be a good neighbor. We don't want nobody losing their jobs here. We got some guys living in Vets Park. We don't want them losing their jobs. You know, it's a tough economy. But just live within the rules, okay? You have the right to be here. We have the right to live here. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you. Next up, I want to introduce Ramona Settner. She's a nurse, and she's here to talk about all of the pollution, how it impacts our communities, and what it means to our health. Ramona.
Hi, everybody. My name is Ramona Settner, and I'm a lifelong resident of this community. You know, I could speak without it, and you could still hear me. I'm from South Chicago. I'm a retired nurse from the University of Chicago Hospitals and a proud member of National Nurses United. Yeah. I'm here today not only as a resident of my community, who, like my neighbors, live with dirty Petcoke dust flying into and onto our homes, devaluing our property values, but I'm also here as a healthcare provider, and as such, I clearly understand the human toll living with these pollutants has on the residents of our community. We've heard about the health impact of inhaling Petcoke particles and the chemicals we breathe in from Agri-fine, but I am here to tell you about the health toll it takes on our lungs, our heart, our circulatory and digestive systems, and who knows how else we will be impacted. I am here to talk about the inhumanity and immorality of polluters in our midst. There is nothing humane about a young child, too young to understand, gasping for air while suffering an asthma attack. There is nothing humane about adult experiencing the complications related to COPD, which is further exacerbated by breathing in Petcoke particles. I may not be able to quote you statistics today, but I can tell you from firsthand experience as a registered nurse, the pain and fear etched on the faces of parents as they watch their child struggling simply to breathe. I can talk to you about the anxiety of spouses and children as their parents' hearts struggle to simply pump blood but cannot because their heart has been harmed by dirty Petcoke particulates or the chemicals from Agri-fine. I can talk to you about comforting families as they hear the dreaded diagnosis of cancer. We all know and feel the health impact of living in our communities, but I am standing here today because I know we have a community where our children can play outside, and as parents, we don't have to be ready with their inhalers. I am here today because I know we can live in a community where the chemicals and the horrible smells from Agri-fine don't have to keep us indoors. I am here today with all of you because our lives are worth fighting for. I bring this message from my fellow nurses from across the city and the country. We will do all that we can to continue sounding the alarm, to continue fighting alongside each of you to bring an end to the occupation of polluters in our community. Like you, I don't think the Koch brothers should be able to make a single cent at the expense of our health. And I certainly don't think they should use a single cent to marginalize us, dehumanize us, destroy our health, our homes, our neighborhoods. We demand dirty polluters out of our community. Thank you very much.
What do we want? Justice! When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
The people! Orders! Stop the odors! The people's
orders!
Stop the orders!
Before I introduce the next speaker, I want to just point out that Chase Stevens, who's running for representative of the 26th Ward, is here today to show her support.
Bring it, Chase!
Thank you.
Jay Travis.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jay Travis.
Jay Travis,
I'm sorry. I thought someone said Chase Stevens. I'm so sorry. Anyway, here's the next speaker is Yolanda Cortez. And Yolanda is with the Claritian Bible School, and she's just going to talk a little bit. She has done work organizing an ecology class, and she has spoke about the Pope's encyclical, about climate change, and I'm so sorry, I can't keep my notes here. And so let's welcome her.
All right.
Hi, Yolanda.
All right.
Buenas tardes. Nosotros somos un pequeño grupo muy preocupado por muchas causas sociales, pero una de las grandes causas que nosotros tenemos es la ecología.
We are a small group that works on different social issues, and one of those important issues is ecology.
El Papa nos ha enviado ya una encíclica que no es un llamado solo a los católicos, es un llamado de atención a toda la gente en todo el mundo. Tenemos que voltear nuestros ojos hacia la creación hoy, ya.
The Pope has come out with a powerful statement in his encyclical that is not just for Catholics, but it's also for everyone in this world, that we change the direction that we're going.
Now. Si nosotros volvemos a los principios, a nosotros se nos entregó una creación limpia. Se nos entregó una creación donde todos pudiéramos tomar un poco de todo sin el abuso de la tierra.
If we think back to creation, this earth was started clean. And we need to turn around and make sure that this earth stays clean.
Y si nosotros tuviéramos que entregar cuentas hoy y entregar esta tierra, ¿en qué estado la podríamos entregar el día de hoy? Es nuestro deber luchar porque se nos devuelva esta tierra que nos fue entregada para todos como una casa común.
So when we started, we want to make sure that we returned, when we leave this planet, that it's in the same way that we found it. We want to make sure that this planet is clean, and that's what we're trying to do. We want to make sure that we organize our...
Que necesitamos regresar esta tierra como se nos entregó de una manera limpia.
Yeah, we need to definitely make sure that we clean, that we keep this earth clean.
Necesitamos practicar también la misericordia. Si nosotros como padres, como madres, hermanos, hijas e hijas, practicamos la misericordia hacia nuestros hijos y el cuidado, también la tenemos que practicar hacia la creación. Tener cuidado y misericordia, porque nuestra tierra, nuestra Pachamama, está sangrando el día de hoy.
No sé qué quiere decir misericordia. ¿Qué quiere decir?
We have to have compassion for this earth. We have to have, we teach our children about compassion, and it's not just for people, but it's also for this earth.
Así que les invito a seguir apoyando a estas personas activistas que son profetas de nuestro tiempo. Nosotros siempre pensamos en los profetas como personas que se quedaron en el pasado, y personas como las que están el día de hoy aquí son profetas de nuestro tiempo que están anunciando y denunciando el abuso a la tierra. Entonces, por favor, apoyemos a estos activistas y pongamos una estaquilla a estas compañías que están envenenando a nuestras familias.
We need to support the activists that have organized this this demonstration. These are modern day prophets that are spreading this word. We need to support. We learned that prophets were from back in the day in the Bible, but these are modern day prophets that are spreading information about keeping our planet clean, and we need to support these actions because it's going to take all of us.
Y solo por último una reflexión, ningún gobierno ni ninguna ley puede pasar por encima del bienestar de las personas, y eso creo que lo predicó Jesús, y eso es algo de un principio del que no nos debemos olvidar. Gracias.
There is no government and no law that should put the people's lives in danger, and that's something that Jesus Christ has said. And that's something that I believe that we need to do. Make sure that we support people's rights, not... And not the rights of the companies.
Our next speaker is our own Bryant Williams. Bryant Williams is the president of the Southeast Environmental Task Force. And he is also the senior director for the Rebuilding Exchange. And if you don't know what that is, it's about recycling things from construction sites and finding another use for them so that they don't get thrown away. We don't waste things. That's our problem. We try, and we should never try to waste things. Okay. I mean, we should try not to waste things. I'm sorry. Okay, Bryant?
All right. Thank you, everybody, for coming out. Thank you very much. Please hold the applause. Now is not the time to celebrate. I prepared some comments, and I'm just so disgusted on my walk over here, seeing slag piles, seeing the staining from the remains of the Petcoke piles, and knowing that there's still more mountains of Petcoke that we have left to deal with. Now is not the time for us to clap. Now is not the time for us to celebrate. Now is the time for us to organize. Now is the time for us to fight. It's time for us to take back our community. For the longest time, I've been on the board of CEDA for a lot of years, and you know, a lot of you have not seen me because there were some more conflicts that I've dealt with that. For a long, long time, we've dealt with what we don't want in this community. And people have called us these crazy environmentalists. So if I'm crazy for wanting to be able to come home and let my kids go play in the front yard, then yes, call me crazy. But I think there's a better way. I think there are ways that we can have jobs in our community, but still not sacrifice our health. I think there's ways that we can have jobs in our community that don't negatively impact the groundwater that we have, the river that we have, that stains the soil to the point that we can't use it anymore. There's a better way, and we're leading that charge. Going forward, it's time out for us to just say, hey, we don't want you here, get out of here. From now on, if you're trying to bring an industry, if you're trying to bring a company into our neighborhood, into our community, where we have to live and breathe, we will fight you tooth and nail.
That's right.
However, if you're trying to bring clean jobs, if you're trying to bring green economy to our neighborhood, we will support you and we will work with you and we will make it happen. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired.
That's right.
Now is not the time for us to clap. Now is the time for us to continue this fight. I just got one question for you. What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
Thank you, folks.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you. Our next speaker is another resident. She's a mother from Callisto School and an organizer for the Fight for 15. She works at McDonald's and has been actively fighting the Koch brothers for opposing legislation to increase the minimum wage to be a living wage. Dora Pena. Dora? Dora?
Sí. Hola a todos, mi nombre es Dora Pena, trabajo para McDonald's. Yo como ven...
Hello, my name is Dora Pena, and I work for McDonald's.
Yeah. Como ven mi camiseta, son parte... Mucho parte. Soy parte de Fight for 15, de la lucha por 15. Podemos pensar qué hace que se unan las dos luchas. Es bien fácil, porque miren, ¿por qué este país solo puede funcionar para la gente rica? Para la gente que tiene...
So we have to think about how we could combine these two struggles, the struggle for a living wage and this environmental struggle.
Ajá, porque si ustedes se ponen a pensar una cosa como Petco, como tanta contaminación, como tanta cosa que le hace daño a lo que respiran nuestras familias, nuestros niños.
So if you begin to think about the contaminants like Petcoke that our kids in this neighborhood are breathing in.
Ellos no van a poner algo así en un una área residencial donde hay millonarios, donde hay políticos, donde hay gente importante, ¿verdad que no?
The rich would never put an area storing Petcoke like this in a neighborhood where they live.
Ellos vienen, hagan de cuenta, a tirarnos lo que ellos no quieren en los lugares donde están sus familias, donde ellos viven.
So they would never contaminate the neighborhoods where their families stay.
Eso no es justo, no es justo, porque yo creo que mis niños, nuestras familias, tienen los mismos derechos que tienen sus familias de ellos, sus hijos. Lo que ellos no quieren para sus hijos, ¿por qué vamos a dejar que nos lo manden a nosotros, a donde vivimos?
That is not just. My family, my kids deserve the same clean air that their kids deserve.
Yeah!
Y es la misma lucha, porque por eso nosotros peleamos, porque donde yo trabajo es una compañía que hace billones de ganancias, es billonaria. Tiene para darnos beneficios, para pagarnos 15, que en realidad ya cuando nos los den ya no nos van a...
Okay. So it's the same struggle. The company that I work for, McDonald's, is a very rich company. They have the money to give us the benefits that we deserve.
Sí, porque déjenme decirles que la mayoría que trabajamos en restaurantes de comida rápida, trabajadores de comida rápida, la mayoría somos madres de familia.
The majority of us that work in fast food, the majority of us are working mothers.
Y estamos preocupadas porque nos alcance para pagar la renta, los biles, para llevarle comida a nuestros niños, lo que necesitan en la escuela.
And we worry about having enough money at the end of the month to provide for our families.
Y a eso le agregamos otra preocupación mayor de lo que respiramos, de lo que hay donde vivimos.
So compound that issue with having to come home and worrying about the air we breathe.
Porque yo pienso, no es justo, mi familia tiene los mismos derechos que la misma familia de cualquier político que vive en una mansión sin preocuparse de nada.
My family has the same rights as any rich person, any politician living in their mansion.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So es importante que les hagamos ver a ellos, decirle, okay, tú quieres ir a vivir donde yo vivo, a mí me gustaría decirle a Dios, tú quieres ir a vivir a donde yo vivo por una semana aunque sea, a ver si él se atrevería a ir a vivir, diría.
I would like to pose a question to this rich person. Do you want to come live for a week where I live?
So es importante, miren, para noviembre 10 tenemos un día nacional de acción para nosotros, que es, vamos a salir a huelga, vamos a estar todos en el centro, en el Thompson Center, a las 4:30, eso es importante. Yo digo que hay una palabra clave, si queremos ganar tenemos que ser todos tenemos que unirnos.
On November 10th, the Fight for 15 will be hosting a National Day of Action downtown at the Thompson Center.
Porque
it's the same struggle, if we're going to win, we have to fight side by side.
Sí, 4:30 de la tarde. Acuérdense que uno, tal vez uno no nos hagan caso, pero si somos muchos, aunque seamos los que limpiamos, los que cocinamos, los que vivimos en un barrio pobre, si somos muchos y nos juntamos como las hormiguitas, podemos llevarnos ese pastel que queremos, podemos llevarnos lo que queremos y que ellos nos escuchen.
Perhaps they won't listen to one, but when we come together and use our power in numbers, there's a lot of us living in this working class community. When we unite, that's when they start listening.
So es importante. Yo los espero a todos. Espero que este día todos salgan. Si quieren que nos escuchen, es importante que
estemos ahí. So it's important. I hope to see everybody there.
Okay. Thank you.
Really quickly. Really quickly, I just wanted to acknowledge some of our partners in the struggle that are here. I see Katie McFadden from the Sierra Club, and some of their volunteers are here. I believe Rising Tide Chicago is here represented as well. And definitely not least, our friends, our family in the struggle, our mentors, our cousins, our brothers and sisters, the Little Village Environmental Justice Organization is here as well. Thank you all for coming. Reclaim Chicago is here as well. Pastor Pan from Wellington Avenue Church as well.
Thank you
all for coming out and supporting us.
Okay, next we're going to hear a short story from Stella Ramos, because she was involved with many environmental fights even before I was, and she's from the South Deering neighborhood, which is just a stone throw away. And as you can see, from all the neighborhoods represented here, we all have the same issues because we are on the southeast side of Chicago.
Thank you. I also want to recognize Pastor Isla from the G2G Church.
Woo!
Pastor Isla. Okay, my name is Stella Rimas. I've lived in South Deering for 70 years. And in the 80s, Waste Management wanted to build a 289-acre landfill two blocks from our school. And what we did is we got together, we went door to door, and you know what? This company was more than a billion dollar company. We broke up their stock meeting, stockholders meetings. We broke up Jane Byrne, who was the mayor at the time, her mother-daughter tea at the plaza. All right. We did so many things. We got arrested for shutting down the Dan Ryan. I mean, we were in the news constantly. And you know what? And Edward Doliak was our alderman who was fighting us all the way. And we won. And I just want to let you know, this is a little dinking company. We can win this.
Yeah!
So don't give up hope.
Thank you, Stella. Next, I'd like to introduce Kate Koval. Kate is going to make some announcements. So if you... Oh, I'm so sorry, Sam. Sam, will you stop hiding in the shadows?
Sorry.
Sam Corona from Rise.
Thank you. My name is Samuel Corona. I'm a lifelong resident of 10th Ward. I grew up in Bush, the shadow of U.S. Steel. So my family grew up in nothing but steel mill industry.
That's right.
And I mean, I've never understood why, because with the steel mill smell compared to Agri-fine, how do we allow this company to sit there and do this to us, to our neighborhood, to our community? How long will it be before our neighborhood is only allowed to walk outside with something like this? Is that the answer we're looking for?
No!
So I'm standing here right here today. 2013, Dick Durbin came out here and said he was going to stand with us.
That's
He's going to stand here, and he's not going to quit until the mountains of Petcoke are gone. Well, guess what? We're still here, and our community is still here fighting.
That's right.
All the members of the coalition and all these equal warriors that you hear out here talking are still going to be here.
That's right.
And the Petcoke piles are just the start of it. Agri-fine is just the start of it.
Yeah.
What do we want? We want jobs. What are we looking for? A clean future, a green future.
That's right.
What do we get? We get lifetime permits for Agri-fine to sit here and poison us.
That's right.
For Carmoose to sit here and poison us. For Petcoke to sit here and poison us. We were given lifetime permits for them to imprison us in our homes. Is that right?
No!
Why is that allowed to happen to us? Because you know what? We used to have steel mills here. What do you expect to come out here? I'm tired of that answer. I know yous are tired of that answer.
Yeah.
So what I'm telling you right now is some of the members of RISE have come around and passed around this little leaflet right here. What we're asking you to do is call up our state representatives,
yeah.
Call up our federal representatives,
woo.
And tell them that the southeast side is tired of this.
Yes.
We're tired of it. We don't want it no more. If they want that industry so much, put it in their backyard.
Yeah.
Eric Holzerman, take Agri-fine to your house.
Woo.
We're tired of it. You know what? I'm sorry I got sidetracked and I had a pretty good speech over here, but you know what? I'm gonna just speak from the heart right now.
Yeah.
I read a quote, and the quote said this. Remember that this land is not given to us by our fathers, but borrowed to us by our children.
Yeah.
So don't our children deserve a better future?
Yeah.
I stand here, right here in front of you, as a father of four, fighting for my kids' future.
Woo.
Like everybody else here is standing here for the better future. So when it comes November 11th, don't forget about us. Come out and visit us. I promise you I'll make some popcorn and have you entertained for at least 20 minutes. All right? Thank you very much for coming out, and please continue to support us.
Yeah.
Join our Facebook page and everything.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so if you guys will bear with me for a minute, Peggy's being interviewed and she asked me to take over. My name is Sheila Garland. I'm with the National Nurses United. And I'm going to tell you, I'm really humbled to be here today. The fight in this community is a necessary fight. It's a fight for our lives, for the lives of our children, as so many have said. And the health exposure and the risks that all of the families who live here take every day is an act of heroism, I believe. And so I am honored to be here. I just want you to know that we have amplified the story across the country. We have over 200,000 nurses in National Nurses United who know about this. When we gather together at our various conferences and conventions, the issue, the fight, and the southeast side of Chicago is always front and center. And we have met with representatives around the state and around the country about what we're dealing with here. And I just want you to know we stand with you 100%. 110%.
Right. Yeah.
So right now I want to bring up Kate Koval. Kate Koval is a mother. She's an eco warrior. She's worked with students from Washington High School. She's taught them ecology and activism. And she taught that course last summer. She has a special announcement. So please help me to welcome Kate. Come on, Kate.
All right.
And her beautiful baby.
Hi, thank you. Thank you everyone so much for, sorry. Thank you so much for coming. We have a lot of ways that you can get involved, and I have a list here. Hold on, I'm trying. I got a baby. Thank you. Sorry, I have this baby here. Okay, so if this is something that moved you, if it made you angry, if it gave you hope, if it, made you feel inspired, then you need to get involved, and we have a spot for you. We need your help. We need more community organizers in order to build community power. We're up against the Koch brothers here. They are currently buying Congress, so you know that's they're powerful. They have a lot of money. And so I don't think that they will win, though. I still think we're going to win, but we need more community power. And to do that, we need organizers. So here's several ways that you can get involved. You can learn more at and sign up for those text message alerts at petcokealerts.org. There's a sign here with it. Somebody had it. I don't forget it. Petcokealerts.org. So this lets you know when the wind is 15 miles an hour. Petcoke dust becomes airborne, putting folks at risk for respiratory and heart problems. You can make a complaint with the city, and that's on that website as well. You can come to, this is super important, you can come to our nonviolent direct action training. So yeah, we're gonna learn how to safely protest in order to apply pressure to lawmakers, local, federal lawmakers, and also the companies. So while we gain media attention, so we want to know how to do this, we want to do it right, and we want to gain power. So if you want to come up to me afterwards and sign up, we have a free training. It's right here in the neighborhood, and it's for nonviolent direct action so we could take some power. Also, come to our teach-in. If you are not familiar with this struggle and you want more information in order to act and fight, come to that teach-in. Like us on Facebook, the Southeast Side Coalition to Ban Petcoke. And our email is banpetcoke@gmail.org. Right. So if you want to interview us, if you have any questions, Baby Rudy, stop that. Just email us. We need you. We are in a huge struggle here, and we are going to win, but we need you all. So thanks so much for coming to our neighborhood, and thanks for being here and sharing this with us. Have a great day.
I guess it's on me. Remember, you should come up here. Come on up here with me. Come on. And so we wanna end it out because this has been a really kind of emotional day for a lot of us. A lot of us have been working for several years on this fight. So when I say ban, I want you to say Petcoke. All right, you guys ready? Ban.
Petcoke.
Ban.
Petcoke.
Ban.
Petcoke.
Ban.
Petcoke.
But I say when, you say now. When?
Now.
When?